The two chapters in this module deal with how information systems can assist managers in making decisions, and we'll also cover a little bit about ethics and privacy issues that have resulted from information systems and business intelligence. Managers have three basic roles. The first role is their interpersonal role. That would be them being a leader, a liaison, a figurehead. They also have the informational role in which they're going to monitor and disseminate and analyze information. And of course, managers have to make lots of decisions. They have to decide how to allocate resources, whether to begin or start a new product or new venture. They're going to be firefighting a lot, and managers will also be involved in negotiations. And all of these require decisions to be made. We said that one of the roles of a manager is making decisions, and a decision is making a choice between two or more alternatives. And businesses are always continually making different types of decisions. And what you see on this slide is a four-phase decision-making model, or the decision-making process. And the first phase is the intelligence phase. This is when the manager examines the situation and gathers the information and identifies and defines the problem or opportunity. In the design phase, the decision maker might often create a model to evaluate the options. Then they're going to test those options using sample data to help them evaluate which decision to make. Once they've done that, then they're ready to make the choice. In the choice phase, the solution or course of action that seems best is selected and it's implemented. Well, in the next phase, the implementation phase, the decision results are evaluated. And if the problem is solved or the opportunity is seized, it's successful. If not, it's a failure, and then they have to evaluate new options and go through this process again. Now, computer-based decision support systems can assist managers in the decision-making process. I just mentioned that information systems can help managers make decisions, but how can they do that? Well, the first is through business intelligence. And business intelligence is a broad category of applications and processes and technologies for gathering, storing, and analyzing and accessing information. And with that information, managers are better able to make decisions. Now, a couple specific tools within business intelligence is the online analytical processing, or OLAP, sometimes referred to as multidimensional analysis. This involves essentially slicing and dicing dimensional data and drilling it down and getting it into a usable aggregated format. We're going to spend some time talking about these in detail, but another choice would be data mining, and that's the process of searching business information from a large database or data warehouse or data mart looking for specific things, which we'll talk about in the next slide. We also have decision support systems, and they combine models to help managers analyze data in a structured or unstructured problem-solving model. In the previous slide, we introduced OLAP, online analytical processing, as kind of slicing and dicing. And here you kind of see an example. So we start with a very, very large dimensional data. We break it down into more manageable pieces. And finally, we deliver just exactly what the user is looking for in a tiny section of the data that we started with. Data mining involves just looking at the data that's out there. And there's two basic data mining operations. Number one is predicting trends and behaviors, or we might identify patterns that we didn't know anything about. Now, data mining can be structured. That's where the miners have a hypothesis or a model that they're setting out to prove or disprove. Or it can also be unstructured, where the data miners just go in and take a look and see if they can develop a model from what they find. Decision support systems are information systems that can do primarily three different things, the first being sensitivity analysis. And sensitivity analysis is the study of an impact of one variable and how it might be affected by another. And this is similar to linear regression. However, sensitivity analysis can also be used when the relationship is not a linear relationship between the two variables. We also have what-if analysis. Using what-if analysis, the model builder makes predictions and assumptions regarding the input data. However, the accuracy of the results are highly subjective because the inputs are often uncertain. We don't know exactly what the outcome is going to be. And then if there is goal-seeking analysis, that's when you work backwards. You have the value or the goal that you're looking for, and then you try to figure out what inputs you need to achieve that goal or output. Remember we talked about business intelligence as kind of the broad overarching thing about what we're talking about with decision support systems and the other factors we've talked about in this chapter. But there's going to be some specific outputs that business intelligence is going to give you. And this slide gives you some examples of some different outputs that you might see. One would be a dashboard. And a dashboard provides an easy way to look at multiple different things at the same time. You might be able to look at profitability or output or expenses from several different aspects of the company, and dashboards were specifically designed originally just for top managers. Then there's also reporting, where you might be able to send somebody out an Excel spreadsheet or a PDF file. And then there's also real-time business intelligence, where you could actually go in and create the queries and the reports that you wanted. Now, there's a couple of terms that you might want to be familiar with. The first two terms here we're going to talk about are push and pull. In a push reporting system, the reports are sent out on schedule and not as a result of being demanded by the user. So we have our monthly report that just goes out to everybody. That's a push system. In a pull report, the user gets exactly what they want when he or she wants it. And there's two more terms that deal with reporting or output of business intelligence, and those two terms are static and dynamic. Static, as the term implies, doesn't change. And so if I send out a PDF or an Excel spreadsheet, that represents the data as it was when I sent it out. That is a static report. Dynamic can be in real time. A dashboard would be an example of a dynamic report because it's going to reflect the data as it is at that very second. And if you do a refresh, then it would change possibly. This slide just shows you an example of a dashboard. So this dashboard gives visual reports of many, many different aspects or areas of the business or the organization, and it would, again, be in real time. Another tool of business intelligence and decision making is geographic information systems, or GIS as it's abbreviated. And geographic information systems can be used to map populations or other demographic features such as income or education levels. And you've probably seen GIS in use if you've looked at election maps, you know, red states and blue states, or red counties and blue counties. That is an example of geographic information systems. This slide lists some common GIS applications, and one of the most common that is used every day by many, many people would be Google Maps. So if you've used Google Maps, you have used a geographic information system. Well, as you might have determined from reading the previous chapter, the amount of information available out there about even you personally is massive, and the massive amounts of personal data that's out there create some issues and even responsibilities for corporations. And so there's fundamentally three tenets of ethics, and that is, you know, what are we responsible, what is our responsibility, what is our accountability, and of course, what is our liability. And the liability is a legal concern as to the rights that individuals have to recover damages if something has happened by their information being illegally released. And of course, information systems and information technology have a lot to do with the ethics and privacy issues that we have. And you know, there are issues of privacy. You know, when you go online, are your searches being stored? Is your personal information being stored? There's accuracy. You know, are there misinformation out there about you? If someone did a background check, would they find things that were not correct? And then, of course, there's you know, who owns what information that's out there on the internet? And then accessibility. Do I have the right, for instance, to see what's out there being stored about me for free? Or do companies have the right to charge a fee for that information? So these are all things that we have to think about when we're dealing with information systems, and we have to go back to those three tenets that we talked about in the previous slide. You know, what is our responsibility, what is our liability, and what is the accountability?